Well, do you want to hear an elephant story now? Okay, I have an elephant story. And it's from an English newspaper. And the English, more than the Americans, the English have a special relationship with things that are wild. They really do. If you follow English newspapers much, you know that their attitude towards nature and their attitude towards things that are alive and that are wild is very different from ours. And it has a lot of odd dichotomies in it, too. On one hand, the English can be, by our standards, extremely cruel towards living creatures. Oh, yes. And on the other hand, they have a strange kind of understanding that's almost Japanese-like, almost haiku-like in its attitude towards living creatures. So they're kind of a split right down the middle. And this is an English characteristic. I remember one time in Wales, I was absolutely completely thrown by the attitude of the Welsh people towards animals. They'll literally beat an animal to death if it's not doing what it should do, a donkey or a horse or something. And I've seen it happen. And yet, on the other hand, their feeling for animals and one thing and another, in a certain way, is very, very different. One thing that they do that we don't do, they treat animals as if they are animals. Americans treat animals as if they're people that haven't started to shave yet. Most Americans, they talk about their dog or their cat with much more tenderness and with more human concern, as though it's a human thing, than they will about their Uncle Fred. Oh, it's a very, very interesting phenomenon in America. Now, they do not look upon an animal in England, or in most countries of the world for that matter, as anything other than an animal. And so, in many ways, their relationship with an animal is healthier than ours. They will find, because they do not use the animal to replace a human being. They do not replace people with cats. They just don't do that. Now their attitude then, of course, is different. Now they will have a certain respect for animals as animals that we don't have. Respect is not quite the same as the kind of sentimental Valentine love that we have for animals. Now here's an example of it. This is from an English newspaper, and it's an account of an elephant. And it's an account in the way the English would write about such an event. And it happened outside of England, but it nevertheless is a report by an English reporter regarding an event that had to do with the animal world. Whoa. Oh. I mean, can't you taste it? Not Westport. This is not a cookout in action now. Very good, very good, very good. The Elephant King is dead. The natives of Ceylon called him Old Charger. He was a magnificent elephant, completely without fear. Old Charger ruled a stretch of jungle through which the Trincomalee Colombo Railroad passed in Ceylon. Everyone who worked on the railway knew him. Old Charger and the train that made the run through the jungle had met many times before. Every 3 days, as the steam engine made its regular trip, the elephant would stand and come out of the jungle to stand on the tracks. The men on the train were not surprised to see him there. They knew that nothing was allowed to pass through Old Charger's territory without his approval. "He would block our train," said one trainman, "and force us to stop. Nothing could scare him. Only when he was good and ready did he let us pass. It was his land, and he wanted us to know it." For years, Old Charger ruled his stretch of track, Then one night last March, the train came through off schedule. A young engineer on his first run was at the throttle. The single headlight on the engine was not working properly. As usual, old Charger came out of the jungle when he heard the train. He stood firm. He stood firm on the track. The train sped toward him through the night. Too late, the engineer saw the huge dark shadow. He blew his whistle frantically, but the elephant refused to budge. The train struck with tremendous force. The huge elephant was carried 150 yards before the train could stop. Old Charger lay sadly silent on the track. His days as king were ended. He was dead. Now that is an English attitude towards an animal. Very interesting story. Now, you see, because the English have spent so many countless generations in the outback thrashing about and you know, thrashing about with the natives and one thing and another. So in the end, you develop a completely different attitude.